DZRH, the Elizalde.
Forget the past, it's time to mend.
A corporate thing.
So, ang sinasabi ko na lang.
Isang mapayapang hapon, Pilipinas! Narito ang inyong balerina ng bayan, si Lisa Macuja, na bumabati sa lahat ng nakikinig sa atin sa DZRH at sa lahat ng nanonood ng RHTV, lalong-lalo na sa ating mga kasamahang alagad ng sining at kultura sa buong bansa. Espesyal ang episode na ito para sa aming lahat dito sa studio dahil ito ang ikasyam na anibersaryo dito sa Art2art. Akalain ninyo, ilang tulog na lang ay malapit na tayong umabot ng isang dekada. At hindi po kami aabot ng aming 9th year kung wala ang suporta ng Manila Broadcasting Company na nagbigay sa amin ng pagkakataong gawin ang programang ito. Ang aming mga sponsors na naniniwala sa aming adhikain para sa sining at kultura, ang aming mga naging panauhin over the last 9 years. Yung iba ay wala na sa piling natin, pero hindi natin sila makakalimutan dahil sa mga naiwan nilang alaala bilang bisita sa ating programa. Ang iba't ibang award-giving bodies na kumilala sa atin at nagbigay inspirasyon na lalo nating pagbutihin ang ating programa. At siyempre, kayo, ang aming mga minamahal na taga-subaybay sa DZRH at sa RHTV. Mula sa aming lahat na bumubuo ng Art2art, maraming salamat po. Mabuhay po kayo at happy anniversary sa ating lahat. At dahil extra special ang araw na ito, sinigurado namin na extra special din ang panauhin. Hindi na natin patatagalin pa dahil ang isang alamat na tulad niya ay hindi na kailangan ng mahabang introduction. Mga kaibigan, ipinagmamalaki namin dito sa Art2art na makasama sa aming 9th anniversary special ang walang kupas na Asia's Queen of Songs na si Miss Pilita Corrales.
Isinilang noong August 20, 1937, si Pilita Corrales ang tinaguriang Asia's Queen of Songs na nakagawa na ng mahigit sa 200 long-playing albums at singles sa loob ng 5 dekada bilang mang-aawit. Bagamat sa Maynila ipinanganak, lumaki siya at nag-aral sa Cebu City bago tumulak papuntang Espanya para mag-aral ng musika. Taong 1958, nang una siyang mabigyan ng pagkakataong gumawa ng recording, isinaplakan niya ang awiting Come Closer to Me sa Australia at kauna-unahang babae na umangat sa unang pwesto ng Australian pop charts. Isa rin siya sa mga unang celebrities na sumikat sa Australian television, kung saan meron na ngayong isang kalye na ipinangalan sa kanya. Nang magbalik sa Pilipinas noong dekada 60, nagsimula siyang makilala sa kanyang mga awiting Ingles at Espanyol na minsan ay siya pa mismo ang nagigitara. Naging regular performer siya sa Manila Grand Opera House bukod sa pagtatanghal sa international circuit ng Asia at Amerika, kabilang na ang Las Vegas, kung saan siya ang unang Pilipinong nagtanghal sa tanyag na Caesar's Palace. Ilan lamang sa mga global superstars na nakasama na niya ay sina Sammy Davis Jr., Bob Hope, Pat Boone, Frank Sinatra, Julie Andrews, Dave Clark Five, Matt Monroe, Johnny Mathis, at Jack Jones. Madalas din siyang magbigay ng command performance para sa mga visiting heads of states at iba pang dignitaries na bumibisita sa ating bansa. Bihasang kumanta sa Ingles, Espanyol, Tagalog at Cebuano. Si Pilita ay naging paborito ng maraming magagaling at maaalamat na kompositor tulad ni George Canseco, Levis Hilario, Tony Marquez, Willie Cruz at Ryan Cayabyab. Di naglaon, bukod sa pagiging mga awit, nakilala na rin siya bilang movie actress at television presenter, lalo na sa mga pelikula at programang may temang musikal. Sa loob ng 5 dekada, hindi na mabilang ang mga tinanggap niyang awards at citations mula sa Pilipinas at sa ibang bansa. Kasama na ang galing sa Philippine Citizens Award, Cecil Award, Aliw Award at Tinig Award. Siya ang unang Pilipinong nanalo sa isang international music festival nang iuwi ang Best Performer Award mula sa First Tokyo Music Festival noong 1972. Noong 1990, tumanggap siya ng Merit Awards mula sa Famous Awards at noong 1991 naman, iginawad sa kanya ang Lifetime Achievement Award mula sa Philippine Association of the Record Industry o PARI. Dahil sa kanyang malaking kontribusyon sa pagdadala ng Filipino musical artistry sa international audience. Ipinagmamalaki ng Art2art na maging panauhin sa hapong ito ang Asia's Queen of Songs, Miss Pilita Corrales.
Mga kaibigan, Asia's Queen of Songs, Miss Pilita Corrales. Tita Pilita!
Thank you!
Maraming salamat, and of course, welcome to Art2art.
Thank you. I think this is going to be very special for me too, because this is my first time. But I would also like to thank you for guesting in Vampire Ang Daddy Ko.
Yes, doon po tayo nagkita last time. Vampire Ang Daddy Ko.
Nag-guest siya for the first time, I guess. I don't think you you do that very often.
Yes, the last time siguro nag-guesting ako was in OK Cafe Rico.
Oh, imagine. Ang tagal na doon.
With
Bossing Vic, Din,
with
no?
Boss,
with Vic
yes,
also.
Yes, yeah. Also with Vic Soto.
Thank you for inviting
that
me.
That was such a really nice experience sa akin.
Diba?
Talaga na,
kasi you're not used to that.
Nakasama ko kayo, nakasama
lahat
ko
sila,
lahat ng si the whole cast
the
was
whole, yes.
Very supportive,
oh,
very
nice.
Great to work with. Mm-hmm. At syempre, ang cute-cute ni
sila Riza
May. Riza May. Oh. And yes, it was a great experience.
It was really very, we were so honored that somebody like you would appear in a small little comedy like that, ma. Because you know, when they said, Lisa Macuja, nandiyan na ba siya?
Hindi naman po. Pero talagang, of course, when I met you, talagang, sabi ko, wow, Tita Pilita, can I guest you in my radio program?
Sure. Actually, Susan has been calling me. Every time naman that she calls, you know, I always had something to do. But today I said, this is it.
Thank you.
It's the 9th anniversary.
Yes, 9th anniversary. Fantastic. So it's a very auspicious occasion.
Congratulations. But, I want to congratulate you for
so
all
much
your awards,
thank
your
you.
Everything. How nice.
Thank you. But I'm sure our listeners are really excited to hear from you. Actually, okay. These days po, madalas nating marinig ang mga labels na world-class artist, mm-hmm. You know. Philippine pride, putting the Philippines on the globe, on the map, you know, and so on and so forth. Arguably po, kayo
That's
yung
true.
unang Filipino artist who really put the Filipino on the world map. Kasi not many people know na you started your career in Australia.
Ah, yes.
And
yes.
Kayo ang unang babaeng nag-number one sa Australian music charts, mm-hmm. in the late 50s.
That's right.
Okay. So,
my goodness.
Bakit
you
po
really
kayo
went deep ahead.
Yes, we researched this. Bakit po kayo napadpad sa Australia?
Because my mother's family already had immigrated, mm-hmm. to Australia, and we were still here, you know, and then my brothers and sisters were still going to school, so, you know, and then she kept on saying, no, you must come here, this is a beautiful country and everything. Mm. But the only thing is, they were already there,
mm-hmm.
and then we went, but you see, what happened is I became instantly famous because we were shipwrecked.
Uh-huh.
So we were in the water for 9 days.
Oh, my Lord.
I was traveling with a magic show.
Uh-huh.
I was the singer of the magic show from Opera House.
At that time?
Siguro you, mga 16.
16?
Because I was in the Opera House. I was the singer of the magic show.
Uh-huh.
John Calvert.
Uh-huh.
Magic show. So from there, we went to Hong Kong, mm-hmm. Singapore, and when we were on our way to do the concert, the appearances in Sydney, we were met by a very big typhoon. So we were in the water for 9 days.
Drifting?
Drifting.
Oh my.
Just drifting until the Australian Navy saw us, picked us up. So when I arrived in Sydney, I was in the front page.
Yes, front page na kaagad.
Front page na kaagad. So it was a little, pero I mean to say, and you know we had animals.
Yeah.
Like we had a very big orangutan.
Mm-hmm. Na shipwreck din kasama ninyo?
Kasi kasama yun sa show.
Okay.
But you know, when they have no food, they become very, very so. The magic show gave it to the Sydney Zoo.
Because I see.
Pagkulang ng pagkain, siguro they become
naging aggressive.
Yes, aggressive.
I see.
We stayed there now, and then since I went already there, then I was in a television program called In Melbourne Tonight for 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
So I used to appear 3 times a week. Uh-huh. And everybody would say, you know how expensive it is also when you have clothes abroad and everything. Mm-hmm. My mother would make my clothes. The program was called In Melbourne Tonight. And 3 times a week, I would change my gown.
Mm-hmm.
Plus the fact that I could sing in Spanish,
mm-hmm.
in Visaya,
mm-hmm.
English,
mm-hmm.
and Tagalog.
Wow.
That's why I was different.
Yes, yeah.
Actually, yes. The one that became the number one hit was, in Spanish, it's Acércate Más,
uh-huh.
Come Closer to Me, which is an adaptation of a Spanish song.
So, Tita Pilita, my next question is, many Filipino artists, once nakatungtong, nakatikim na sila ng international stage and international success, hindi na sila bumabalik sa Pilipinas.
Actually, so, I was really offered to stay.
Uh-huh.
I was offered citizenship. I was offered everything, you know.
So why didn't you stay in Australia?
Yeah.
And why did you come
back? Now you think like that.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, my family could not take the cold.
Mm.
It was too cold
masyado
in Melbourne.
Malamin.
My brother was working in a gasoline station. His hands would be very...
Mm-hmm.
So we decided to come back. Of course, I didn't want to stay there also by myself.
Mm-hmm.
And that's when I started
here. It was a family decision.
Family decision.
To move back to the Philippines.
Because they could not. It was just too cold. Melbourne is very much colder than Sydney. So. That's why we decided to come back, and maybe like that. But I'm sure there are many also that probably make a name there, and then they just come here to visit.
Mm-hmm,
Siguro.
Mm-hmm.
But with us, it was the whole family.
Mm-hmm.
And then after my father died, I had to do the raising up of the whole family.
Uh-huh,
you know? So.
Uh-huh.
And
kayo din ang naging breadwinner ng family niyo.
Ako.
Nag-alaga.
Kayo
na po lahat.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then that's when I became a comedian because I didn't speak Tagalog.
Mm.
I could sing in Tagalog, but I didn't speak. So that's why I became a comedian because they would give me scripts in Tagalog.
In Tagalog.
Oo. Grabe, you know.
No, and of course, you've
things
worked
that
with,
happen. Oh, yeah.
You with legendary composers. And I think.
Oh, composers, you mean Filipino, yeah?
Yes. Talagang parang nakakabit ang pangalan ninyo, of course, with George Canseco.
Because of the songs, no?
Kapantay, Ay Langit. Which is a modern classic, really.
Actually, mm-hmm.
Can you tell us the story kung paano kayo nagkakilala ni George Canseco? What's the story behind the song as well?
Well, actually, the song, you know, I had Your Evening with Pilita on television for many years. We had a composer's portion.
Mm-hmm.
And so when he came to the studio and said, this is my composition, it was in English, You're All I Love.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the first time I saw him.
Mm-hmm.
But from then on, he just kept on writing. Meaning to say, whatever I recorded as a female would be the same recorded by Basil.
Mm-hmm.
Si Basil ang male, ako ang female.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's why in the new duets album I have, Basil asked for Kapantay Ay Langit for both of us to make a duet.
Wow! And it's now, it's really a classic.
Well, yes, every time I do a show wherever, hindi mo yata kinanta yun. Or sometimes, million thanks, kinanta ko na po, nilagay ko lang sa medley. Ano ba yung medley? O sige, kantahin ko na lang ulit.
And of course, syempre, Tita Pilita, we cannot really have a concert or a performance of yours na wala ang inyong signature backbend move.
Akala nila talagang
ginawa ko. Titiklop na kayo and magbe-bridge stand na habang stand, holding your high notes. So is this signature move something that you thought of or
no?
Paano ito naging
before
trademark?
Kasi when I started I was like this, uh-huh. And so every time I would go on the stage somebody would be the so I stand straight na uh-huh, naman uh-huh. Then on the other side yun na say, but I found out that by bending uh-huh. I could reach a higher note uh-huh. So I kept it uh-huh. So I let's see. Say, for example, if the note is very high, if mm-hmm. I don't bend, hindi ko maabot.
Ay, hindi nga maabot?
No.
Ah.
Because this way, your lungs expand. Eh. Uh-huh. So you have a longer breath.
Okay. Yun.
Pero I kept it na lang. At least, ako lang ang merong ganyan.
Oo nga. Pero bakit hindi ko pa rin maabot yung mga notes kahit nakaka-backbend?
Hindi mamaya pa sa dahil sa'yo, maano mo yan. Aabot.
Wait, surpresa po natin yan sa mga listeners. Okay. Huwag muna nating ina-announce.
Huwag muna. Sige. Huwag muna.
Pero nabisto na ata tayo. Pero sige. Well, okay. In the span of us,
so many years.
Your really long career. Uh-huh. You've been able to work with so many different big mm-hmm. musical mm-hmm. celebrities,
yes.
So many legends in their own right. So who were the most kumbaga parang unforgettable international artists that you have worked with?
They are all unforgettable mm-hmm. because I've worked with many, but the most unforgettable, I think, being the greatest entertainer in the world was Sammy Davis Jr.
Wow.
Uh-huh. I was his front act here. Uh-huh. And then he said, I'm going to take you to Las Vegas. Yes. I'm the only one who can take you to Las Vegas because because he used to tell the story of how when his father mm-hmm. was the headline mm-hmm. of the Caesar's Palace but had to go through the kitchen mm-hmm. because of his color. Mm-hmm. No, mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. not this time. Mm-hmm. When I say I want to bring an unknown person, mm-hmm. I can do it mm-hmm. already.
Yes.
And you know, after 2 or 3 months, he called. Of course, you just say, thank you, sir, thank you.
Yeah, uh-huh. Thank you. And hindi niyo akalain na mangyayari yon, no?
Hindi, uh-huh. hindi talaga. Uh-huh. Yeah. And then it happened, and Ryan, you know, it was a 40-piece orchestra, a little bit smaller than when you sang. 60-piece yung sayo. Akin 40 lang.
64 po.
Oh, 64. And he conducted, it was really amazing to see a total performer like him. Mm, mm. He would, and you know, the most exciting thing is that, you know, me, an unknown, mm-hmm. at that time, Lisa, the highest two rollers were Spanish speaking. Mm, mm, mm-hmm. So I was the first one who could go and sing in Spanish yes. for the high rollers
yes,
and everything. No, uh-huh, uh-huh. Pero he would say, he would sing 5 songs, he'd go in, puta barong Tagalog, uh-huh, and uh-huh. then he'd come out and introduce me as the star of the show. Uh-huh. Di ako'y nanginginig na. My knees were already
yes,
shaking, you
of
know,
course.
I was so, ano, pero...
Of course.
That's why, you see, that's why I always say, the more talented you are, the humbler you are. Mm-hmm. There are so many artists na, you know, okay nga, they're a big name, pero ang yabang naman, mm. I've worked with many like, mm-hmm. not mm-hmm. this one, mm-hmm. this one. Mm-hmm. He knew nobody mm-hmm. could do as he does, mm-hmm. no? Mm-hmm. Sometimes he just go in the stage, he will sing, he will play the piano, he will play the drums, mm-hmm. he will play the mm-hmm. whole instrument. Mm-hmm. So, mm-hmm. very few people are like that. So, mm-hmm. it was an experience, a very, very big experience that you will never forget.
Yes, of course.
And then all the rest naman, you will not forget. Mm-hmm. But then there are people that really... Mm-hmm.
That really stand out.
Yes. Okay. And the good thing is when you're in a dressing room, you're in a beautiful dressing room in the Caesar's Palace, and you have a grand piano beside you in your dressing room.
Spoiled po ang mga artists doon.
Doon, di ba?
Especially now.
Especially now.
Yes.
So.
Marami pa po tayong pag-uusapan kasama ang ating special na panauhin sa ating 9th anniversary special. Walang iba kundi si Miss Pilita Corrales. Dito pa rin sa Art2art. Magbabalik po kami pagkatapos ng ilang paalala.
Programang hatid ay sining at kulturang para sa lahat. Magbabalik ang Art2art. Usapang sining at kultura para sa lahat. Kasama ang balerina ng bayan, si Lisa Macuha. Art2art.
Kasama pa rin natin ang Asia's Queen of Songs, the iconic Miss Pilita Corrales.
Iconic?
Iconic, yes. The legend, the
masyado
iconic.
Masyado ng maraming mga Asia's this song, Asia's. Kaya madali na lang yung Pilita Corrales, tapos na.
Tita Pilita.
Yes.
Kayo po ay, of course, na-expose na sa maraming mga singers.
Mm-hmm.
And you have been a judge in many singing competitions.
Yes, it's true. Like X Factor.
Yes. Ano po yung masasabi ninyo sa yung style ngayon na mga bata nating mga singers na yung tinatawag na birit, yung pataasan at palakasan ng boses,
yes.
And minsan sigaw na, parang hindi na kanta.
Ako talaga,
yung ginagawa. Is that really what people are looking for now?
Well, because we have had contests, mm-hmm. on television, mm-hmm. you know, to look for the Miss Birit Queen, mm-hmm. Miss Birit, so they will make birit.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean to say, for me, mm-hmm. birit is not singing,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Can I quote you on that?
Yes.
Birit is not singing.
If you're going
take
to make
note.
Birit, the okay. whole song,
mm-hmm.
you see, because we have so many singers that are so very good with birit, they are in tune and everything, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But you cannot, let's say, get a romantic song and then you're going to make birit the whole song, you know. The louder you can go, you know, that's it. That's
diba,
the best.
Masakit na sa tinga.
Yes, yes.
Hindi na maganda pakinggan.
Let's say, if there is a concert,
mm-hmm.
and somebody is making birit, it makes the audience uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
Aabot ba siya? O hindi, baka naman hindi makaabot.
Mm-hmm.
It makes the audience feels like that. Mm-hmm. They're not comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Mm-hmm.
There are birit queens like Regine Velasquez, for example, who can make birit, but she has the softness too.
Mm-hmm.
She has the vocal dynamics to go high and not shout.
Mm-hmm.
You know, to go mm-hmm. high and not make, and so many other singers that we have like
mm-hmm.
that.
Mm-hmm.
Pero when it is all birit from the beginning to end,
mm-hmm.
no.
Mm-hmm.
For me, that is not singing. There's no heart.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Kailangan yeah. pag gumanta ka, you have to have a little heart
yes.
in each song, depending on what you sing.
Mm-hmm.
That's my opinion lang naman, no?
Yes, opo.
Pero I know of many na ano, I used to like her better before when
yeah.
she was not singing like that now. But because it became the fashion,
mm-hmm.
who can sing the highest and the loudest,
mm, the loudest
everybody
yeah.
tries to do it,
mm-hmm.
no?
Mm-hmm.
Kung kaya mo, di okay, but mm-hmm. you cannot do it all the time. It's not pleasant
yeah.
anymore. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And did you take singing lessons po?
No.
No, mm-hmm. no? Talagang natural po lahat.
Parang talagang God-given na yun. You know, before,
yes.
before you would only take up voice lessons if you were going to be a classical singer.
Mm.
Like my auntie was a teacher, mm-hmm. Lu Corrales de Razon. She was teaching in mm-hmm. UST, classical.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, when we came to Manila the first time, my mother said, hey, maybe you can teach Pilita to sing,
mm-hmm.
you know,
mm-hmm.
since you're a... And he says, no.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if I teach her to sing, she will lose her style.
Mm-hmm.
You know, then
mm-hmm.
she won't have her own style anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But
mm-hmm.
kung classical singer ka, talagang you have to. Yeah. You
so,
have to learn.
Tita Pilita, how did you develop your style then? If you did not take lessons?
You mean well, you know, the voice is already there.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. The voice is already there. You know how to sing. Mm. You have good timing, mm-hmm, and everything. When I was growing up in Cebu, mm-hmm, when there was a party, it was always me singing, mm-hmm, you know. Mm-hmm. Of course, I would sing only in Spanish and in English. Mm-hmm. But I knew that I had the voice, yeah, already, yeah, you know. And mm-hmm, then, you know how it is that, you know, after my father died, you know, before, kasi, I don't know, you know, before, if you were in show business, you were not supposed to be coming from a decent family, mm-hmm, a mm-hmm good family. Show mm-hmm business? Mm-hmm. My mm-hmm goodness, for my children. But
it
you
was,
see,
no, scandalous.
Yes. No? If I didn't know how to sing, what would happen to me? Di mag-hostess na lang ako. No. Honestly, at least I thank God that He gave me the yes talent that I was able to, you yes know, yes, to do what I have done.
And you know, aside from singing, of course, you mm-hmm went into acting on television,
yes,
in the movies,
yes, guesting in the movies.
You became a host.
Yes. So, Bagong Kampiyon.
Yes.
Tanghala ng Kampiyon. Uh-huh. Yes.
So, Tita Pilita, do you miss it?
You mean to say the contest?
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, how do you call this? Like now I'm doing comedy.
Mm-hmm.
And then I also appear in some teleseries, which is, I never do drama because I don't know how to do drama.
Mm-hmm.
My daughter is good, no? In the drama, mga drama. Pero I love to host.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, I'm still doing so many shows,
mm-hmm,
live shows, yes, already, no? Uh-huh. Doing concerts and everything. But I miss, like, I like to host kasi.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I learned so much from Bert Marcelo in hosting, mm-hmm, at that time, mm-hmm, no? Mm-hmm. Oh. Mm-hmm. But I love to judge also.
Mm. Uh-huh. Yes.
Because that's uh-huh where you can discover.
Yes. Yes. Well, speaking of judging and the birit and the, mm-hmm, the self-taught singer and performer that you are, ano yung maipapayo ninyo, mm-hmm, sa dami nyong achievements, ano yung maipapayo ninyo sa mga batang mga singers, actors, actresses, mm-hmm, out there na gusto ding marating ang narating ninyo sa inyong career?
Depende talaga kung singer, kung gusto nila maging singer, mm-hmm, you know, like for example, ngayon, yung mga our time that you didn't need to take voice lessons or anything, naging ano na yan ngayon eh, mm-hmm, you know, all these contests, you know, mm-hmm, they already bring their children to learn in a school, mm-hmm, for singing, you mm-hmm know. Nowadays, even the professionals take it.
Mm-hmm.
But what they do not take voice lessons, but they take for extension.
Mm.
No? Para humaba ang breathing.
Mm-hmm.
Even professionals do that, mm-hmm, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And also for, how do you call this? Preservation of voice. Yun. Mm. Yun, you can take that up now.
Yes.
But before, there's nothing. But you know, for children, let's say for example, we, like you have the voice,
yeah,
where you discover all these wonderful, young, talented na ano.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, Lisa, you really have to like what you're doing,
mm-hmm,
you know.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, if you want to continue in this business and becoming a singer or a stage actress or something, you know, you just don't do it. But you see, we cannot also help that. Most of the people who join this contest is, the reason is financial.
Mm. Yeah.
Baka manalo ng house, mm-hmm, and lot. Baka mm-hmm manalo ng ano. It's a good thing that the let's say for the kids, talagang marunong kumanda,
mm-hmm,
you know?
Mm-hmm.
But if, for example, if it were not something like they need the money or they need, ano, mm-hmm, it would be so nice if parents could send their teacher to learn ballet,
mm-hmm,
to learn singing, to learn any instrument, yes, in music.
All the arts, performing arts.
Yes, and, yeah, oh, uh-huh. Kaya lang, mm-hmm, you know, that's the way it is here. We, yes, cannot. Mm-hmm. Ano, pero mm-hmm I advise them if they want to. What happens also, Lisa, is show business now is so different. Eh.
Mm-hmm.
Now you have a handler, you have the manager, mm-hmm, you have. We didn't have all those things before,
mm-hmm,
no?
Mm-hmm.
Well, wala namang ganun. Pero nowadays kasi, especially singers and actresses and youngsters, mm-hmm, very spoiled.
Mm-hmm.
they have everything given to them. You don't even have to bring your clothes. The stylist is there. He will dress you up and everything, you know. But when you started, when we did, we knew what to wear or whatever, no?
So, ibang-iba na po ngayon.
Ibang-iba na ang panahon. Yeah. So, they're very lucky,
feeling,
I tell them.
Feeling entitled na po yung mga ibang younger
performers. Pero paminsan-minsan
na,
naman. Yeah. Minsan-minsan naman itong mga... You know now, Liz, eh? I mean to say, you're doing a recording, eh, medyo out of tune ka dito, isang ganun ka lang.
Auto-tune.
Andyan na.
Isang pindot na lang,
ano? Hindi ganyan.
Hindi ganyan noon.
You have to see, so everybody can be a singer nowadays.
Yes.
It's good. Why not?
Including yours truly.
Of course.
Yes.
Exactly.
Na magsisegue na po tayo dahil anibersaryo natin ngayon. Mapalad po tayo na mabigyan ng espesyal na pagtatanghal ng ating natatanging bisita. Okay? At may sorpresa maya-maya. Pero hindi pa
yun ang mas exciting.
Mas exciting talaga.
Yun.
Medyo namamawis na ako ng malamig dito. Mga kaibigan, for the first time dito sa Art2art, the epitome of the global Filipino artist, ang nag-iisang Miss Pilita Corrales.
Lagi kong dasal sa may kapal ang lumigaya ka. Kahit ngayon mayroon ka ng ibang mahal, hinding-hindi pa rin ako magdaram. Sakaling paluhain ka, magbalik ka lamang, naghihintay, puso ko't kaluha. Pag-ibig ko, kapantay ay nangitirang, hindi sakaling paluhain ka, magbalik ka lamang, naghihintay, puso ko't kaluha. Pag-ibig ko, kapantay ay langitin. Hindi magbabago kailan pa man.
Woo! Wow! Thank you, thank you so much, Tita Pilita.
My pleasure to see you. But you see, I also came here Because when they invited me to do your Art2art, they promised that we were going to sing together. Susan. She called me by telephone.
Teka muna.
Sinabi, so, pwede ba?
I know. Ito kasi yung pinilit ko talaga yung sarili kong kumanta dun sa last show namin ng Rebel, that's ng Ballet right. Manila.
Somebody
talagang sinabi ko kay Joanna Ampil, Joanna, bigyan mo ko isang stanza sa handog ng Pilipino sa mundo.
Ayun pala eh.
Ako yung kakanta, ha? Siyempre, hindi naman siya makahindi kasi ako yung producer. So, ayun, nakakanta ako with the 64-piece. ABS-CBN Orchestra, Philharmonic Orchestra, under the baton of Maestro Gerard Salonga. So ngayon, matutupad na rin ang pangarap kong makaduet.
Pero hindi naman ito 64-piece, pero pwede na rin.
But kaduet ko si Asia's Queen of Song, Miss Pilita Corrales. Oh my God.
So
talagang hindi kasi ako yung host ng Art2art. So, syempre hindi sila makahindi. So, ngayon, for the first time, yes.
In Art2art.
Dahil 9th anniversary ng Art2art.
Exactly.
A very special
duet.
Episode. Duet. Yes.
Sa buhay ko'y labis.
Ang hirap at pasa. Tayo dito. Oh, okay. Sway.
Sway. Yeah.
Tsaka yung backbend ko po.
Oh, sige.
Dahil sa'yo.
may recording na kami. Naku, you're so good. Tita, you just don't feel comfortable.
Tita, kayo na lang ang mag-extro. Since inagawan ko kayo ng eksena.
Hindi. Oh,
kayo na lang ang ano. Hanggang sa susunod na linggo. Maraming salamat, Tita Pilita. At binigyan mo po ako ng...
At least merong programa na ganito na pwede mong ipakita sa tao na meron kang konting brain.
Salamat po! Salamat po sa pag-guest ninyo dito sa amin sa Art2art. Maraming salamat sa kauna-unahang pagkakataon na ka-duet ko po kayo.
Pumayag po kayo.
Maraming salamat. At maririnig na rin ang kanta ko sa buong archipelago, sa buong lahat ng DZRH. Oh my God!
Everywhere, okay. Diba? Thank you. Maraming salamat din sa inyo.
Hanggang sa susunod na linggo, samahan ninyo kami ulit dito sa Art2art, kung saan ang usapang sining at kultura ay para sa lahat. Ito po ang inyong balerina ng bayan at singer na rin, Lisa Macuja, nagpupugay sa artistang Pilipino.